Well, that was easy.
It didn't do that freaking crap that it does every day, where it's like,
Yeah.
no.
Aiden is back. Right
Hello,
away.
Aiden! Welcome to the stream.
I don't even know what we're gonna do.
I'm gonna play some LSD Dream Emulator, since I kinda wanted to play some of that.
Yeah.
And then we're gonna play Spook Game.
Oh boy.
And, when we get to the spook game, you guys probably know it because it's a classic spook game, but it's pretty much the only thing I could think of. So, yeah. Anyways, gonna
Yeah,
hide
so what I
Raven
did was,
tonight. Alright, let's check if the audio is correct before I.
so I was back on that server, and like that Star Trek server, and well, I pretty much went around and like flew around like world downloading everything. Even though they like pretty much said that you can't world download our maps. Blech.
They basically, I mean, they own it, but they don't because.
There, I mean that's probably the most authoritarian Minecraft server I've ever seen. I'm like, they deserve this.
Yeah. Halloween hack. Actually, I didn't even think about that. We could play Halloween hack for like
That'd be pretty cool.
super Halloween, but like, or either that, or I could just like go find it right now. Cause the game I was originally going to play is a classic RPG Maker game that I managed to find. Probably the oldest version of it I managed to find. Like. Already wineskinned since it's RPG Maker, so
Yeah.
just got that.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just cute. Can the stream, does the stream work? Like, does the audio work on the stream for both of us? 'Cause
Checking the audio device again just to make sure. Got everything set right, looks. Well, you got Action 52. Well, I
the
can't even
audio
remember why.
works.
I think I just wanted to stream some bad games. And originally, I was gonna go Action 52, and then play some like bad anime games. Which I got another bad anime game. This one's a Dragon Ball Z one, and it's really bad.
Oh boy.
But we're gonna wait. I need at least one more bad anime game before we can do a stream based on them. Originally, I was gonna have Robopon be the third bad anime game, but it wouldn't cooperate no matter what we did to it.
It just
So,
refused to be streamed.
yeah. I refuse to be wronged. The audio is fine for now. It doesn't screw up. Alright, now let's. Oh, yeah, and I also quickly pulled up the closest thing Mac has for MS Paint and made a cover art for Pokemon Quartz version, which I might have to do a stream on in the coming months because that's a one heck of a Pokemon ROM hack.
Is it like a Pokemon ROM hack
Yeah, it's a Pokemon
or is
Ruby
it
version ROM hack,
yeah?
and it's something.
So is it like a Chinese bootleg or something?
Well, it was made by a guy on the Pokemon, like, the Poke Community, I think is the name of it.
Yeah.
It's a Pokemon fan website where they do a lot of, like, hacks and whatever. This was, can't remember what years this was made in, but it was made by a guy whose internet name is Baro, and he made his whole entire Pokemon hack. He did it all by himself, including the art. But the problem is that Baro can't art very well.
Yeah.
So the results are special. Yeah,
That's going to be interesting to see.
And also, he redid the entire three regions worth of Pokemon under his original Pokemons.
That's a lot of Pokemon to do.
Yeah, so I commemorate him on his effort,
Yeah.
but there's a few things that make Quartz kind of a bad ROM hack, but we will see that
At
someday.
least he tried.
Yeah, he did definitely try. He tried pretty hard, actually. But yeah, some of it. Anyways, LSD Dream Emulator.
I'm gonna try to draw Xatu in MSN Paint,
Oh
capital
no.
A.
Just to freaking download the sprite and call it good.
Yeah. Like, just don't even color it or anything. Just, like, rip it, and then it's my sprite, guys. Honest.
It's the controls. Uh-oh, cutscene started. On. Forgot the controls for this. Hold on. Oh, it's been ruined. It's weird.
Is it frozen?
No, it's like, it's so weird.
The screen doesn't
Shiny.
show anything other than just a frozen image. Is it
Yeah, it's
paused?
not frozen. I have it paused. You can't see me yet at the controls. Because it opens a different window.
Yeah. Oh, you're rebinding it.
Yeah.
Rebinding the controls, I mean. I should show you this world download sometime. It's insane. Like, I literally just flew around for like 5 hours. And because they're all like watching your every movement. Like, because they're like terrified of it getting downloaded.
Oh, wow. That's hilarious.
So it's like I had to play that off like I'm just exploring, guys, honest. Like, except I actually had to, actually be good at it. And from what I can tell, I think I got away with it too.
Doing like, how did I forget the? Okay, here we go. Like, for some reason, the bindings for like one of the analog sticks was gone, which doesn't make any sense. Right.
Probably when you were messing with it yesterday, or whenever.
Yeah. Maybe Chrono Trigger somehow screwed up OBS. I don't know.
Like, you know when on Chrono Trigger, like, switched cores, and you don't even know, and, like, we don't even know how it did.
I see what's wrong now. You need WASD for this.
There's a video recently posted about this game. It's like is the emulation subreddit. And it's like, there's a video posted to this game on the emulation subreddit.
Yeah.
And like, isn't a special emulator that removes all the twitching and warped textures. And it makes like it smooths out the textures so it's not blocky.
Does
Only
it?
thing is that this is one of those games where that's kind of intended.
Yeah. Because honestly, this game could have looked a heck of a lot graphically better. But I
They
think.
would have made it worse.
Yeah. Because it's already not a very, super, greatly designed game. Its whole
Certainly
intention
not
is
conventional.
atmosphere, not gameplay or anything.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's the end of the dream. All right.
I don't like how when you wake up, it just goes to the thing.
Yeah.
That's like the only thing. Like it just, when you wake up, this is the real world right here, is this screen.
Yeah. Welcome to the real world, your life. Oh, great, a text stream that we can't read.
Yeah.
I mean, I could pull up Hold on, let me do that real quick. Let me see if I can make it worth it. And go to the wiki.
Wasn't there a like in the remastered version that someone made, like they translated all the text?
Yeah, which is something I do appreciate.
Yeah. Only thing is that it lacks the texture warping.
And also the polygon count is too high.
I think it's about the same, but
Like, there's some stuff, like, alright, so, in the natural world, there's some, like, rocky hills or whatever, and they're, like,
yeah.
made out of triangular polygon shapes, but in the remastered version, they made them out of squares for some reason.
Yeah.
And it's just kind of weird. Alright, let me see
What
if
I
I can
should have
find the
done was,
same dream as the one listed here. Probably can.
they should have made the remastered version, like kind of like Doom source ports. And I know this is a weird comparison, but like Doom source ports need the original game to work.
Yeah.
But the what they gain out of that is that it looks exactly like the original game and plays exactly like the original game. But it's still, you get the advantage of like a modern engine and everything.
Hold
They
on.
should have done that for this.
Yeah, they really should have.
'Cause that way it would have been like all the graphics would have been identical. They could have figured out some way to add the warping textures in like as like a graphical option or whatnot.
Yeah. All right. So what this says is Onsen Traveling House and film viewing. I came to old Onsen Travel House. A lot of people were gathered there watching some film. Viewing it is required. I blended with the crowd and watched the film projected in the reception hall. Yoko-chan from my class whispers to me, "There's a blonde person behind us." Oh no. Not the horrible blonde person.
I'm
Also.
pretty sure that's a nightmare.
Yeah. Oh! No, this is what was behind them. This is what was behind them. It wasn't a blonde person. It was Aiden's MSP. Yuzantu. It's amazing. Okay. Let's continue. Oh, wait, I gotta pause. Cool. Also, I liked how you completely overused the spray paint tool, like everyone did.
Yeah.
'Cause it was so cool.
Like it's so bad, like the spray paint is so overused that it's like it's solid colors in some places.
Are you freaking kidding me? More text. All right, let me find this a bit quicker. The full LSD experience. Where is it?
RSD.
I have to find this by looking at the kanjis. Okay, here we go. Holding my hand. Then the car, as if drifting into the old tree center, runs toward the house. The late great grandmother came out. "Came back from you, didn't you?" she said while passing away. She held my hand.
Sounds kind of powerful.
Yeah. Which is actually based off of an event in LSD Dream Emulator. Or it's not based on it. The event in LSD Dream Emulator is based on that dream.
Yeah.
Where there's like this old lady in the Bright Mood Cottage or whatever, which is the hotel.
Yeah.
There's this lady who sometimes appears who's like this dying old lady, and eventually she just becomes a skeleton. And then the next day, if you see her again after she's become a skeleton, she'll be back to regular lady.
Yeah.
gonna draw myself an Emerson. Immortalizing yourself in MS Paint.
I'm reminded of that flip note you did of Sonic. Or Sanic, I mean.
Yeah.
It's too easy to run into things in this.
Yeah, especially with the clunky turning. Cause I mean, you think freaking like the original, like the original Resident Evil had tank controls. This is real tank controls.
Yeah.
You have to stop to move anywhere and slowly turn. Where you could kind of still a little bit keep moving in Resident Evil. Unless you're shooting your gun. Oh yeah, Danic. Is Danic your own original Sanic character? It's really terrible when the parody of Sonic also has OCs based on the parody of Sonic. Like, I'm not even joking. You get variants of Sonic.
And are you... Like, do you mean that, like, the parodies are also parodies?
Yeah.
Or...
Oh, speaking of which, I Hate Everything, a YouTuber that I watch.
Yeah.
He does, like, rants about he hates, like, random things that just bug him. He just does a rant on it.
Yeah.
But it's really well done. Like, it's got good editing, and it's really funny. He recently made, today, a video entitled I Hate Parodies, or Parody Channels, because there's actually an entire community of people who are parodying I Hate Everything.
Oh, yeah.
Like, there's at least over 100 different people parodying this one guy's YouTube channel. There's a face on the wall. Scary.
I wonder what they think of it. Like, I wonder if like they just see this. I wonder if they just see him as whining. Or
well, there are some people in the comic section. Like, I think that they don't. Like, if you're talking about how the parody channels see him, they probably see him as his god or something. Like, that's what he said in the video. It's like I'm some kind of weird YouTube god. But I think, like, a lot of- he's- oh, wow. It's rare. Crystal in the sky. So, a lot of people have- like, over the course of IG's- that's his, like, nickname, IG.
Yeah.
His real name's Alex. Like, IHE's fans or people who've watched his videos, he's gotten called out several times for being whiny or whatever, or he should stop hating everything. But in reality, a lot of it is just he makes YouTube videos for the fun of it.
Yeah.
And also to sometimes make people angry. And Zatu will haunt your dreams.
Oh, I remember there was a picture of, I think, like, a Kikui.
A what?
Skyward Sword.
Like, a the Kikui and things. Skyward Sword?
Yeah. It's made during some Metroid marathon. I think it's 2012. And it looked kinda like that.
MS Paint Kikui.
Yeah.
Kikui's name was probably Quacko or something.
Probably.
You have like Koopo and what is it, like Kui or something.
I don't know.
Like they all have names with a K in it and an E sound or an O sound. So it'd be Koopo.
Yeah.
Here's how I look now. Nice! I really like the detail on the ice. Very good. That's how you do a... You know, if anyone tells you to make a self-portrait and you don't know how to draw faces very well, then just do that. You know? Because
yeah.
You've drawn yourself.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's more like
No, you mean...
Oh, crap.
You mean you've drawn myself.
Yeah. You can draw a portrait of anyone if you just draw myself. And
mm-hmm.
also, I got attacked by the Green Man. Which isn't such a problem, since they don't really use the playback feature anyways. I accidentally ran into the bridge. All the textures have been weirdly normal. It's wrong. You have, like, crazy textures. So this fog is not great. I don't like this fog.
Can't see. Makes you wonder what's ahead of you.
Yeah.
So
even though you know what's ahead of you, since you know everything that's in the area, but...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like, playing this game alone, after you've gotten to where it's all weird, is not an experience that... No way, Greyman. But it's not an experience that is, very fun, usually. It's usually kind of spook. Just because...
So does this game have screamers?
This game, the closest thing to the screamers I could think of is maybe, like, accidentally being jump-scared by a low-poly model when you slowly turn around.
Yeah.
So sleepy in case my Amazon saw two behind it. It's like, Pokemon being haunted by their terrible Pokemon red and green version pixel arts. So we would be okay. So I'm now in desert land. Aliens.
This looks like the like I used to run a Minecraft, not modern Minecraft, classic Minecraft.
Yeah.
Like Minecraft Classic, I used to run a server. I don't know if I showed you.
Yeah, you did.
And there was like a mountain map that was kind of like this.
It's sand or whatever, it's some grass. In fact, I could probably remake this on Minecraft real easy.
Probably.
Like the whole of natural world.
Mm-hmm. Probably remake the whole game like this.
Yeah, just because of how low poly the thing is.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm gonna do that, then I might as well just... I don't know, would I... If I did this, would I do it on vanilla or Feed the Beast? Feed the Beast means I have more options for kinds of blocks. But vanilla means...
You could make a texture pack.
Yeah, I could.
And then have command blocks, and then it would actually be like this game.
Yeah. Oh, snap. Yeah. Still looking into making a texture pack or whatever. I think the wiki has some, like, texture sheets that people ripped. So I could just do that. Freaking love that. You walk to the Geodude guy. And he just freaking stretches.
Oh. He turned into... I don't even know. He turned flat, though.
Yeah!
And
sorry,
then he teleported into this...
Hmm?
What's that noise?
The Tengu... Oh. Okay, then! Surprise! The Tengus make the noise. The Tengus were those, like, ninja guys running around. They're like a Japanese mystical creature. Back here, and we also still have the oppressive great. Makes you want to go back and listen to this game's soundtrack again. Also, note that this soundtrack kind of sounds like the freaking Mario theme where you're like trying to, in Mario 64, go up the stairs.
Yeah, I know that one.
It just sounds like that, only a different sound, but.
Yeah. It's really funny how you can just backflip up the stairs.
Yeah. Like, ultra backflip.
Yeah. Did you see that video about, like, I don't know what it was, but it's like, there's some Canon Coic video about Mario 64.
What was
it? I don't know if you watched. Is the guy who does, like, you know, like the half A press guy.
Heck. I don't know if I watched it or not.
You don't know, like, the beating Mario 64 in, like, a half A press?
Oh, yeah, the half A press. Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about a user or whatever. But yeah, the half A press.
Yeah, that guy. And he made a video about, like, Mario's speed or something. And, well, I mean, well, Mario can basically go infinite speed.
Yeah.
So we do have confirmation that Mario is faster than Sonic.
Yeah, especially with glitches.
Oh, yeah. Even with glitches, like, the Sonic glitches that, like, there's a glitch in Sonic Advance, like, the first one.
Yeah.
Where you could, like, you'd mash the spin dash button frame perfectly, and then you'd, like, go shooting off the screen at, like, speed.
Yeah, and it's weird, because I own that game, but I've never done that before.
Mm-hmm.
I have tried to complete a whole level backwards with Knuckles, though, since he's so broken.
Yeah.
But yeah, Sonic Advance is, like, my number one Sonic game, just because it's the only Sonic game I've ever played that I played at a pretty young age. I think I was maybe 8 when I got it. Okay. And but yeah, it's a good game. I always use Knuckles though because he was the easiest.
Yeah.
Like literally, you can complete anything with Knuckles.
Anyway, about that game. Like, in that game, there's a glitch where you can, like, yeah, you mash frame perfectly in the spin dash and go super fast. But even that speed is nothing compared to Mario.
Yeah.
In Mario 64. You know, like, you just go off the screen in Sonic. Like,
mm-hmm.
You know, you go fast, you can go through walls and whatnot. But, you know, Mario can, like, break the game with how fast he goes.
Yeah.
I think it's, like, backwards long jump up an elevator for, like, a minute. And then the game freezes because you literally hit infinite speed.
Infinite speed, yep. Oh, speaking of infinite speed, did you see that Vinesauce stream where it's, like, he was playing, what is it, Super Toad 64?
Not really.
Like, it was...
I know what you're talking about, but, like, I don't remember this bit. Like, what was it?
The whole game of Super Toadio 64? How...
Yeah.
So, apparently, it was a hack. Like, it was some guy's, like, hack that he was doing, but people kept, like, telling him to finish it faster, like, they kept hustling him. So
yeah.
He just released this broken, awful hack where every, like, slight move, the Toad, the Mario who's been reskinned as Toad, goes
Yeah.
flying. And it's hilarious. Like,
Yeah.
Vitty couldn't even play the game. It's amazing how he got one star. And he did actually get one star. I think he got more than one, but I can't remember. Because literally, you just nudge the control stick, and he goes. And then if you try to crouch, he goes faster. And
Wow.
it's ridiculous. And the only reason that hack was made is because the guy was getting really annoyed by people like hustling him because they kept wanting his hack to be done faster.
Yeah, I can like that. That's a really funny. That's really funny.
Yeah.
Still not as fast as Mario.
Like, I mean, you could see Toad fly across the screen when you have true fast Mario.
Yeah,
You can't
I mean,
even see
like,
it.
with Mario, like, you know, Big Rig's Over the Road Racing.
Yep. The
The
classic.
one where you can go like warp 9,000, but
Yeah.
only in reverse. Guess who's faster?
Mario. Just undoubtedly Mario.
I mean, and at least in bit like in Big Rigs, well, for one, it takes over an hour to go like fast enough to break the game.
Yeah.
And it's
In
really funny
Mario, it
because.
takes no time at all.
It's like, I can't believe we're talking about like how fast can game characters go with glitches?
Yeah. Oh, don't even get me started on the fact that the clearly fastest character in the Sonic series is Dr. Eggman. Since he can completely and totally outrun Sonic every time
Yeah.
on foot.
Can never be caught in.
Oh man, are we back here? This is like Kyoto music. Yeah.
I wonder if Mario could beat Dr.
Only one way to find out.
Eggman.
Next time, on Game Theory. Thanks for watching!
Oh my God.
And we'll also finally, at long last, find out who is Sans? Is he Ness? Or is he Steven Universe? Because Steven Universe is like the exact shape of Sans. Oh, hi! Got the
Wolf Elemental.
Whisper! Hopefully. Welcome back to the stream, Wolf Elemental. Just playing some LSD. And I'll be playing a spook game later on. Though, I
Yeah,
guess it's kind of deciding because, Aiden presented an option I forgot existed, so I might do that instead of the spook game I was gonna do. And if we do that, then I'll tell you what spook game I was gonna play instead. So I think a cutscene is supposed to happen. This leg here, but it's not doing it.
It's okay, I don't know either of them because I'm uncultured swine.
Well, it's not like a super. It's Markiplier played it, but he played it years ago. It had this weird thing where it came out and. Alright, so it came out in Japan, and then, like, a year later, it got really, really, really big in the, like, horror Let's Player community, which was still kind of small at the time.
Yeah.
And then it, like, died off, and no one remembered it.
How are you all today?
is Captain Charlie? Is he JonTron or is he? No, Captain Charlie is John Cena. Moonside. I've got it all wrong. I mean, he's got the green. Because John Cena's got the green. He kind of looks like John Cena if he had some kind of mustache thing going on. So it's clear. It's clear that Captain Charlie is indeed John Cena. Y'all doing today? I'm doing fine.
Well, yeah.
Kind of tired, okay. But otherwise fine. For the moment, at least. I was doing really bad, like, earlier. Like, I felt freaking awful. But I'm pretty alright.
What do you mean, yesterday?
Hmm?
Or, like, earlier today?
Earlier today.
I'm glad you feel better.
Hooray! That was the spark. It's weird because this one room, the only thing that really happens in this room is that sometimes there's a sparkly above the chair.
So other than that, it's like, it's not really anything.
Yeah, it's just throne room. Ah, dunk. What's on the ground? Sands.
Still kind of messing around with this world download.
Are the worlds really that big, or are you still just, like, finding new worlds to download?
I'm in this, like, the Star Trek map room.
Yeah. You mean Stalin's Star Trek map thing.
Oh. Though I'm not really doing anything in it. It's just like, I'm just... It's that time when you're in Minecraft and you're not really doing anything. You're just like walking around aimlessly.
Yeah, that's basically almost every time in Creative Fun.
Kind of missed Wolf Elemental.
Yeah. Glad you're back. You get a free invisible stream cookie as your welcome gift. Yeah, but what do you get when you mix yellow and blue? I don't know. I'm thinking maybe like red. Yeah. That's how you do it. That's how you colored, you know. See the new horror flick. Ouija. Whatever it's called tomorrow. Hopefully it's good and not complete garbage like it has the potential to be.
Yeah.
But usually horror flicks with Ouija boards are horror flicks that aren't good. Because I've seen many, many a Ouija board horror flicks, and many of them have not been good.
Yeah, I kinda don't really need to see anything like that.
Yeah, the spook... Like, I guess it just depends on, like, who you are, who likes spook movies. I like
yeah.
Scary movies and whatever. But what I don't like is scary, or scary with big quotes, B-grade movies, because those are just a waste of my time.
Yeah.
I mean, some people like it, some people just like it because it's stupid or whatever, but it's a little bit too stupid for me, which I know sounds crazy, considering, like, I guess my humor style or whatever, but yeah, there's some things that are too stupid for even me.
A Luigi.
No. I think it could just be called a Ouija board, but... Oh, crap.
Oh, boy.
Green man,
I think
right.
I know where you're going with this.
There. That's how you spell it. just, you don't have to put the loo in front of there. You already got all the material you could do to completely botch Ouija boards.
Oh, yeah.
In its name. Sun. Some nice black sky.
And the 5 FPS.
Yeah. It's another thing that this game is known for. Not only is it known for its stellar graphics, but also its amazing frame rate.
Yeah.
Which can dip to about 3 frames before, which is ridiculous.
That's not even really video, that's like a slideshow.
Yeah. And it's only really done that if you, like, have a bunch of stuff going on, and then you walk into, like, a wall. And Link, which is what it's called when you transition to a new area or whatever. What the heck is that? Oh, it's just a sign.
The buildings are really small there.
Yeah. Like, look at that! That's not even really a building, it's like a cheese grater that someone colored some highlighter on.
Yeah,
a big cheese grater. Hey, a spaceship.
It's
for
2005
YTPs. YTPs never die. Got the Zatu drawing done. Oh man. Bitch,
I think
it's
I think I mentioned this in a comment like before, but like, you know the website Quebec Gamers?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure the only reason they still exist is because YouTube poop.
It's gotta be the only reason, or else...
Like,
or
I
else
mean,
it wouldn't
at...
be top search result when I search up cutscenes for Hotel Mario.
Yeah, and I mean, it's like... I'm pretty sure the people who pay for their server costs are the people who make YouTube poops, because...
Yeah.
I mean...
I don't think they've updated, like, I haven't really screwed around there since it's in... like, French, and I unfortunately can't read French.
Yeah.
But I don't think it's really updated anymore.
Yeah. I mean, look at the graphics. It's like 2005 graphics.
Yeah. Thankfully, it's not the grotesque website graphics, like what
yeah.
Joel found. If you know the stream, the, like, Vine Sauce charity, he went to a bunch of awful, grotesque websites that were actually even older than 2005.
Did he get banned?
He didn't get banned, but, I mean grotesque as in whoever designed the website, it was clearly their first time, and it was also probably the first time they ever used the internet. So they got all the CAD GIFs, and all of the GIFs of, like, freaking rainbows, and all of the MS Paint
Under
spray
construction.
Tool. Yeah, it was Windows Destruction. I think it was the follow-up video to Windows Destruction that he made, like, after the thing was over, but he wanted to continue it. It was after
yeah,
his
like...
first, tryout with the memes virus.
I said all the under-construction GIFs.
Yeah.
Like, all the spinning and construction tape. Things.
Yeah, or that one, like, it was like a fashion website or art website or something, but its webpage was horribly atrocious. Like, the webpage looked like just, oh man, I don't even know how you describe the webpage. It had, I think it had, like, a poorly drawn MS Paint peacock on it.
Yeah.
And that was definitely kind of a bad website. World building is art. Yeah, all of this is art.
Yeah.
Anything can be art. Even memes. Unfortunately.
They just get overdone.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that in the beginning they were all hilarious.
Of course they were, or at least someone had to have found them hilarious. Snap. We have a chance for a cool thing going on. Let me get in front of this, and we gotta look at it.
That's almost like, you know, like a hipsterism or something.
Yeah.
Cause that's like not liking what's popular, I think. Even though that's kind of like a paradox. It's like division by zero.
That was a good dream end. Life is a meme. Yeah, that's... like maybe that's the reason why we're all mortals. Because we're memes. And memes are also mortal. So after you get overdone, it's like you don't exist anymore. Just get pushed under the heaps of internet garbage. Till the day you're reincarnated and... I am in the air. I move, I'm gonna fall.
Is this a glitch?
Maybe not. What the heck is this? Oh, okay, now I fell. Alright.
So was it a glitch?
I'm guessing so, because you're not really supposed to spawn on the nothing.
Yeah, you just spawned out of bounds.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure they found that, it was a legit glitch when they were making the game, and then they found it, and they're like, leave it in.
Alright, another tech stream. What is this? It's not that.
More gibberish.
Yeah. More Asianese. So it's like two characters, but I'm not seeing. That's not it.
Unfortunately, I don't see any smiley faces in there.
Yeah. Just looking for it, but there is none. Where is it? Alright, so it's like, it's got a... I don't know if that's the title or the... Yeah, that's the title on the other side.
Oh, this picture's done.
Oh, snap. Alright, hold on. I need to find the text stream. I'm on the wiki. Gotta read it to you guys. Do they just not have it here? That'd be terrible. Man, so it's got...
incredible.
It's gotta be somewhere on.
Blavo.
They don't have the text stream on this, apparently. Makes me disappointed, because now I can't read it to you guys. Alright, let's see is amazing. Oh my god! Wonder what that reminds me of? That reminds me of the episode of SpongeBob. Where SpongeBob was asleep and Mr. Krabs was trying to, like, get him to give that soda drink hat back or whatever. And, like, Mr. Krabs drew a ghost on a paper and hung it through his window on a fishing pole. And it was just, like, this paper ghost over SpongeBob. And SpongeBob wakes up and is, like, terrified. And was painted Zatu Wolf. That's what that is. Yeah. Man. The haunting shopping list!
Yes.
Alright, I can't actually find the dream for you guys, so I'll just go read a different one with two characters. for the title. Loneliness. Come from a place far away. Further, I am really tired. Why is no one waiting for me? Even here, I am alone. I don't have a place where I belong, and I don't have any place to go. Spooky dream. Or more like, not really spooky, but kind of... I don't even know. I've had many a dream that isn't, like... Ever had a bad dream that wasn't a nightmare, but it was still bad?
Probably, yeah.
I've had many of those.
Yeah.
And those are really annoying, too, because they aren't bad dreams, because you weren't scared of anything. It was just a bad dream. Like, it was too weird or whatever.
Oh, yeah, like most of the bad dreams that I've had, like, recently, like, aren't really things that I'm scared of anything, but
yeah.
More like...
It's just an unpleasant dream. An unpleasant dream.
Like, most of my bad dreams, this decade have been, like, psychological horror.
Yeah. Psycho horror dreams is basically all I've really gotten. Mm-hmm. I can't remember. Well, I've had, like, a few dreams. I think I had two dreams where I woke up to, like, the sound of a power drill or whatever. And I'm not even joking. Like, one dream, I just sort of woke up from a dream, and, like, it was dark. Like, it wasn't morning or anything.
Yeah.
And so I, like, heard a power drill, like, drilling into the wall or something somewhere. I was assuming on the roof. Like, maybe it was maintenance going on that I didn't know about.
Okay, so is this like a false awakening, so you're like in your room in this dream.
Yeah. So I just sort of, I'm just laying there, like, I've got the cover, like, over me, because
yeah.
I usually sleep under the covers because it's cold in my room. And
yeah.
So, like, just sort of laying there, listening to this power drill, and, like, wondering, like, what the heck is going on, seriously? So
yeah.
Eventually... Like, I sort of, like, make myself get up, and it's gone. And so I ask later, like, I ask my mom, hey, was there, like, maintenance going on the roof later? And I think it was 6 o'clock in the morning, so I don't know why I'd ask that other than the fact. But my mom was already
so
up,
was
because,
morning.
Like, she gets up really early. So, I'm gonna run into the tower of British land. But, yeah. And so I asked her, and she was like, no. So I was like, oh.
Did you tell her about it?
Yeah, I told her about the dream, how I, like, heard a power drill. And it's weird, because this isn't the only time that I've heard a power drill. There was another dream where it was, like, a flat-out false awakening, where I had, like, woken up, or I thought I did.
Yeah.
And I just vaguely remember myself, like, half asleep, getting up, going to the bathroom, and getting a drink of water because my throat was dry. And then going back to my bed, and as soon as I got back to my bed, I woke up to a freaking loud power drill in one of my ears. And so I get up and I was like, what kind of stupid prank is this? And it was 4 o'clock in the morning.
And no one was there.
Yeah. And I was like, so I watched YouTube and then I went back to sleep.
I know what that was. I know what that's like.
Yeah, it's...
I remember one dream, like, I don't even know if this is a dream, but, like, I remember waking up, and the light is always on in my room. Like, it's just always on. And I just tend to go to sleep with the light on. Not because, you know, like, it's just because the light's always been on. It's not real... It's like one of those lights that you can't really turn off.
Is it like a monitor light or whatever? Or like...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, what do you mean?
Like, you know, you turn off a computer, but it's got a light still on it.
Yeah.
To know that it's plugged into power. It's like one of those.
I think it's more like a, like the light. Well, it's actually a regular light, but... The power, like, the switch is on the ceiling. Like, I actually made the thing. and the power switch is on the ceiling right next to it. So if I wanted to turn it off, I'd have to get up and then stand up and then turn it up, like reach to the ceiling and turn it off.
Yeah.
So most of the time I don't. And this is back in the day when there's like a bed in the middle, so like there's a mattress in the middle of the room. Anyway, I don't think it was that time. It was like, but the room was really messy, I know that.
Yeah.
So I didn't really care. So I remember waking up from this dream. Like I didn't even remember the dream. I remember waking up and I could like see. I remember like opening my eyes or something and I could see the light. Right? I could like see the light
Yeah.
and the ceiling around it.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, pop! Like, I think it was in my left ear. Like right next to me, like an electrical pop.
Oh, meh.
And that woke me right up.
Of course.
And I didn't even know if this is a dream either. Like, I know it was when I was waking up, but when I woke
It
up.
sounds so real. Like, I legit thought it was like a power drill or whatever. But it wasn't. And I know, I
Yeah, and
think
then.
Joel talked about having those, where he like heard a shotgun once next to his freaking ear. And he's just had that pretty much all his life.
And then, so, like, yeah, I woke up and I, like, checked around my head, obviously. And I didn't find anything. I, like, smelled, like, I tried to, like, see if there was, like, any ozone or something, and I couldn't, like, smell any. So it's like, but I guess it was just in my head.
Yeah. Saw two picture. Yeah. Have you ever had a dream where you Oh, I love that. The kid describing a dream. Also, hi, Ceiling Waffle. Welcome back.
Ceiling waffle.
Yeah, he's been to a stream before. I think it was also an LSD dream, but hasn't been back in a while. So yeah, welcome back. But anyways, in all seriousness, have you ever had a dream that you woke up? We're doing daily routines. I think I woke up like or not like I had a dream where I went to school once, but it was like really quick. And I also had a dream where I was eating like some cheesecake that was in the fridge, but I didn't actually eat the cheesecake.
I don't remember. Like, I don't really have them because I don't really have much of a routine, to be honest. So it's like kind of nonsense for me.
Yeah. Like, I haven't had one of those in a long time.
Yeah. I've had plenty of false awakenings, but none of them were like about like routine because.
Hello, sir. Yes. Kind of looks like JonTron. Just like, you can kind of see the JonTron right there.
I've had plenty of dreams where, like, it was like it was a dream about some, and then you wake up, and then there's something on the TV, and it's like, this sounds familiar. And then it's like, yeah, I heard this in the dream.
Never
You know,
really
like
had
where,
that.
like you go to sleep with the TV on, and then you
Yeah.
dream about the thing on the TV or something.
I think I had a dream while listening to the LSD Dream Emulator soundtrack, which is hilarious, but I can't remember it. I wish I could, though. It was probably great.
Shared the stream on Remy's Discord as usual. Maybe you should like actually I wonder if Remy should like check the stream out again because we're better now.
Yeah. I need a freaking, like, I need to go to Remy's settings. Because I have her as a friend. Need to do that after stream, but I have her as a friend. On, like, the Twitch thing. But,
Yeah.
like, since you have to, like, after you have to go, like, change the notifications on and off. to like get the notifications for when people stream to come up.
Yeah.
I've never seen one of her stream notifications come up, so I'm assuming it's off, so I need to go fix that.
Yeah, I don't. I never really have my email.
Yeah, she did come by, like. What was it? It was another LSD Dream Emulator stream, I think. Yeah, I know she loves this game.
Yeah.
It's going to hangar number Japanese letter.
I guess Minecraft really wanted me to watch the stream. Because it just straight up closed on me.
Well, I was like, stop playing me! Watch your daily LSD Dream Emulator!
It's like, I thank so many, like, you're not here, and it's like, Aurora's up to, where is she? I miss her so much, and then you come on, and it's like, oh.
Oh crap, Super.
And then, yeah, and then I just play Minecraft during the stream that I waited so much for.
A collection of old Pokemon drawings I made when I was 6. No wonder you're scared. Super short dreams, usually, and I imagine something happened that later, the thing I dreamed about happened. I had like a dream where my mom bought some benches to an apartment, then 1 year later after the dream we moved to an apartment and she brought a wood bench inside. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Another cutscene happened. Yeah, I've had a lot of really stupid, like, weird nonsense dreams that have nothing to do with anything. Like, I actually have, like, I guess after this LSU Dream Emulator stream, I'll pull up my, little dream, like, I write down my dreams in typing form. So
yeah,
I'll pull
really
that
cool.
up and I'll read a few off of the list. Some nice short ones.
That'll be really fun, cool.
I guess. Cause my dream- I can't even really describe my dreams, cause they're so freaking weird.
I remember, like, just this morning, when I woke up, and then, like, you know how you wake up, but you're not really awake, it's like you're half awake, and you still, like, you know that you woke up and that the dream has ended, but you're not really entirely awake.
I've never really, I mean, I've had a, like, you know, false awakening thing, like, once. Maybe another time, which was probably that other paranormal noise. I haven't really had anything like that yet, though. Probably to finally get somewhere, though. Because I've had, like, at least one time where I actually revisited a location from another dream that I actually didn't even write down because I didn't need to, because I remembered pretty much everything in it.
You said, like, another drill noise. But there was another one?
Yeah, there's another dream journal of mine that I'm working on currently. Like, because when I wake up and have a dream, I just, since my iPad's, it sits in the, like, plugged into the charger on the table right next to my bed. So I just wake up and I grab my iPad and go into, like, the notes and just write this stuff down. You're lying.
I was saying, like, you mentioned the power dream. Like, was there another dream that had that?
Yeah, there was, alright, so, it started out being a dream, I think it was about, like, I think the dream was that I saw just a few, the dream had something unrelated going on, and then...
Just hit the mic, I'm sorry.
They create their whole lives on their planet. It's super long. What is it really? Oh, so you just type random stuff?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's one way to type. But, anyways, like, with the dream that I had where I revisited a location, the dream started off with me seeing this sort of, like, sort of like a bent road, like around a corner, and it was in some kind of housing district, like apartment district or something. Like there was rows of houses. They weren't apartments, but they were like I think it was like military housing communities, since I've seen many a military housing community. But like it was like this corner sort of curve, and it was in daylight, like broad daylight. But the cars were going really freaking fast around the curve, like as in blinding speed. And I think I was wanting to cross the road, but I didn't because the cars were going way too fast.
Yeah.
And then the dream in which I saw that same place again, it was like the dream was me out at a park somewhere. But it was getting late, so I was gonna walk home. But then it was dark, and after coming through some bushes from the park, I was standing at that same position that I was in the other dream, thinking about crossing the road at that same intersection, only now the cars weren't there, because it was night, and it was also snowing, but it was the same intersection. And eventually I did actually cross it, and found out that the place that was supposed to be like the thing, like the row of houses, actually ended up being an apartment building with like poor ghetto sort of buildings in there. It's really weird. What is that that's being typed into the chat? He has no style. He has no grace.
Oh boy.
This cone! It's a funny face. CG coconut gun.
Conky dong.
DK Donkey Kong. How does it go? It's like I can't even remember it right now because this music is annoying. Just run into pink foot with Japanese text. You ever heard of Plants vs. Zombies? My brother used to play that all the time. Are you talking about like the old like chess, not really chess, but like strategy game? Or are you talking about the like Team Fortress style remake that they did?
Never heard of it.
It's like, I don't know, because it was originally, Plants vs. Zombies was originally a mobile device like strategy game. You try and defend house using plants that stop zombies. But then they made a like a multiplayer shooter game called Garden Warfare, where you're defending like a base from a team of plants versus a team of zombies.
Yeah, I've heard of this.
It has its FPS set up in the Team Fortress 1. Yeah, I hear it's actually pretty good. It's funny because I remember having a dream about Space Harrier once, but I don't remember any of, but he was in it. I've had many a dreams of, like, I don't know, like, I go through these, like, these, I guess. Also, I've never seen this area before in my life. Hold on. What's this? Is that like cities?
I don't know.
There's like cities in the world. I'll go there. But, I've had many a dream that is just like several dreams that are related to each other in the same room of dreams. Like, when I was really into Pokemon, pretty much every dream that I had something to do about Pokemon, even if it didn't start out like that. Like, it would be some dream, like, I think it was a dream of me exploring the city, or whatever. And then I went to this back alley, and there was, what is it, like, the Venus Flytrap Pokemon, Carnivine, one of the newer ones.
Yeah.
It was in the alleyway, and it started, like, making angry sounds, so I turned around and left. And then I was in a park that was full of Pokemon, and it just continued on from there with Pokemon.
I've not really remembered much dreams lately.
Yeah, I've...
It's just most of the time is... Like, I know I have them. Because I remember
yeah.
them.
Like,
kind
well,
of
man...
Weird, like,
sorry to cut you off, but, actually, continue.
Like, I remember, like, the only really thing I remember about them is I remember waking up and then remembering them, and then forgetting them. Like, I'd wake up, and then for, like, the first minute be perfectly clear. Like, I could still, like, go to anywhere in that dream, like, from in my memory. And it would be perfectly fine, and then after a minute, it's gone.
Oh, man. Like, I've had dreams like that. Or either that, or I had this dream once, in which, like, things were going on that I thought were important, so I literally remembered to tell myself in the dream, and this is the only thing I remember about the dream, remember this dream, because it's important. And guess what? I forgot the dream. Within, like, 3 seconds of waking up, I opened my iPad. I was gonna start, like, typing, but I couldn't remember anything other than the fact that it was important to remember it. And it was just... Oh. Man, it was awful.
I guess it wasn't important, though.
Yeah. I was like, oh man, this is such a perjury. I think it had something to do with, like, video games or anime or something.
Yeah.
So it's like, alright, so this is important right here. This is some important crap that just happened. So I gotta remember this. And of
yeah.
course, I don't.
Have you ever read Minecraft Dreams? I think this is, like, after I went to bed after the stream last night, I just had, like, Minecraft dreams.
You anime?
I don't
yeah.
remember. Don't remember anything. It's just...
Mm-hmm. I've had an Minecraft dream. A single one that I can account for in turtle. Actually, no, tortoise. But the single Minecraft dream that I had was really weird because I could... Like, it happened fairly recently. I think it's in my, like, the dream journal volume 2 that I'm working on. In
yeah.
which, like, it started out as some kind of... I was playing, like, the Catamites games. Like, you know the Catamites, the guy who made the Space Funeral. And he played, like, he made some more games that Benny played on stream. He makes, like, the weird, sort of, like, intentionally crappily drawn and made games. But
yeah.
I was, like, having a dream where I was playing... Oh, I paused. I keep pressing that button. Also, there's no music. It's not great. It's gonna run too well. But it was, like, I had... Like, a dream where I was playing some new... The Catamites game. Where it had, like, ghosts or whatever. And it was in the city, but it was really low poly and had flat textures.
Yeah.
And then... Like, I think I saw some ghosts that looked like ghasts from Minecraft, only they were smaller. And then I was in this, like, snow biome part of the dream, where it was a snow biome in Minecraft, and I was flying, I think, down a hill, like, in creative
yeah.
mode. Only there was a texture pack on, and it made the snow, like... The snow... Bye then, lady. But the snow was, like... It had some... Like, it wasn't completely flat texture, it had some... little cyan dots in it, or whatever.
Yeah.
To kind of give it some color. And there was some spruce trees and whatever. And there was also some wolves. And the wolves also had, what, some kind of texture pack on. And I think this was, like, supposed to be a freaking... still the Catamites. Oh, crap. Stupid gray man. But it was supposed to be, like, the Catamites' texture pack for Minecraft, which he probably has never made or played, maybe. So it didn't even make sense. But it was, like... The wolves had a texture on them, and they were red, and had this kind of, like, crappy pixels all over them, and they had this thing around their collar of the model that were, like, spikes that I think were supposed to be, like, spiky fur or something.
Yeah.
And so, after that, I got to the structure that was kind of like a beige castle someone built, but there was no towers in it, and I couldn't see over the wall. And then it turned into this weird World of Warcraft stream with, like, realistic orcs or whatever. Fighting realistic versions of the wolves. And it was just really weird. And then it ended. And that's... I might have had another Minecraft stream. But I don't think it was recent, and I can't remember it if I did.
I know I've had a few other Minecraft dreams. Like,
I still remember one dream when I was little and I fell down a hole in my house. The hole was not deep, but I looked up, it looked like it fell more deeper. I've had freaking... Man, when I was... Crap, like... 4 or 5? I had dreams of, like, pipes, like, you know, drain pipes or whatever, coming out of the walls and just freaking, like, attacking me. And I don't know why, but it was super scary.
Or how about, like, just, like, random areas in your house that don't exist, and then you go there and it's, like, an adventure or something. Like, it turns into a dungeon or something.
Yeah, I've had, like, a few, like, dream replicates of my house, or rooms in my house, that are different, but I've never really had a sort of domino effect where you go into a room that doesn't exist and start going into more rooms.
Yeah.
I've had a lot of, like, places where I go into, like, completely unfamiliar areas that start having domino effects.
You know what I've, like, you just reminded me, like... I would have, like, I've had a few dreams that was, like, the opposite of that. Like, I would be, like, in some unfamiliar area, like, just trying to get somewhere, and then I'd end up in my house somehow.
Oh, wow.
Like, I'd be in some, like, pipe area or whatever, and then I'd just fall into my, like, I just, like, go through a hole, and then it'd be to my bathroom or something.
It'd still be like,
a dream version of the house.
Yeah.
But, you know, like, the rooms are all, like, a little bit different, but, you know, it's recognizable.
Mm-hmm.
I've had that a few times, actually.
Yeah, I guess the reason why I just never had, like, a whole lot of dreams involving house exploration is because I moved so much. Over, like, I've moved freaking, like, 5 different places in my lifetime. Because of the military and whatever. So, like, yeah.
Yeah, I've lived in this, like, house. Like, I've lived in this house all my life.
Yeah.
So, I had a lot of dreams of it.
Yeah, I've never, not really for me, because, I mean, I've had dreams about like places I've been, but never have I really had a dream about me being in a current area, and it's so weird. I don't get it. So it'll be
Like you're
like in a
getting
freaking area that I
somewhere.
remember from Germany or somewhere, and like crap goes down, and then yeah.
I was anyway. I don't know if I told you like this one, but like I remember like there's this dream that I had, and it was years ago. But it was like a strange, like I don't know. I remember. I barely even remember this thing now, but like I remember like waking up or something. Or maybe I was playing Metroid or whatnot, and I was in my neighborhood. Yeah, I was in my neighborhood, and then I like got outside. Like I went back in my house, and there was like apocalypse on TV or whatever. Like it's on the news or something. And then there was like a so I go downstairs, like into my basement, and it's like all the walls are like wooden when it's really like brick walls. And I go onto the
Oh
bed
crap, it's kind of scared me.
down there, and it's like, and I wake up again. Yeah, like I wake up, like I have like a false awakening, and then I get, get up, and it's still the same basement. There's a bunch of guitar strings on the ground, and go upstairs. There's this big hole in the kitchen floor, like that's like a, like there's just dirt underneath, and then there's like a TV in the kitchen that has like the same apocalypse events on it.
Renovations. Dream house
Yeah.
renovations.
Oh yeah. I wake up again, and I go upstairs, and the I look out the window, and it's just a void,
Yeah.
and like just a black nothingness
Yeah.
into oblivion outside, and I look in the middle of the room, and there's like an old computer in the center, which I turn it around, and like I think my parents are there or some, and they're like, I was supposed, and I said something like, I was supposed to give this to someone, I forget who, but like I was supposed to give that computer to someone. And then I wake up again, and I'm like, at this point, I started to realize how much times I was
Oh
waking
crap.
up.
My belly.
So I'm like, is this a dream? Like, I was thinking to myself, is like, I bet I'll wake up again or something. Like that was my thoughts. And then I would actually, like I went upstairs again, and there's like, I looked outside and it was like all the leaves on the trees are gone. It was like fall or something. And there's like a, oh, there's like a miles per hour sign in the middle of the yard. And it's like 58 or something. I think it's
58
58
through
at.
your house.
Yeah. And that's like, the number on the sign is the amount of days that you have left until the apocalypse or something.
That sounds like classic dream nonsense. That's trying to make sense. When dreams try to make
Yeah.
sense, it always ends up being like that. When they try to tell a story.
Even though it's just gibberish.
Yeah. It's like, I'm trying. Do you see it? Are you appreciating it? And it
Though
comes
you
off as
do actually
absurd.
appreciate it in the dream. You know, you think, oh, it's a nonsense dream. You don't think it's nonsense in the dream.
Yeah, because it's
And
like
that's.
freaking dream language. Hold on. Aiden's got a dream. Had a dream my dad throwed a toy in the woods and I ran after it. And right as I set foot in the woods, there was some random person's house and they tried to kill me. And right before they did, I woke up and I had stuff like that when I was little. It's crazy.
Yeah.
If you start making games, could you send me them to me to beta test? Well, I gotta get a laptop first. It's not like I got anything better to do right now. Yeah, I'll finish this dream. And
I
I'll go pull
remember
up
there
my
was
dream
a.
journal stuff, and then we can decide whether or not
Yeah.
I'll pitch the idea of one of the like first horror game I was planning on playing. And then if it's yay or nay, we'll pit that against the Halloween hack.
Anyway, I was thinking like I remember having dreams like I was like on a big like it's like a ship that had containers on it, like a barge or something. But it was on land for some reason. And I'm just standing on that and I jump off or something happens and I jump off and then I hit the ground and then I wake up. I guess I died, but
Yeah, wasted.
Yeah. Oh man, the amount of dreams that I have that it's like, I don't even know how to describe. Like, I remember there was this dream that I had. I remember being in this room. I might have been like a school, but it's like the back part of the school where, you know. There's no classrooms, it's just like and stuff. You know how it is,
Yeah.
like you got them like janitors that are
Yeah.
there, like or something.
All
And
right.
in one of those
Gonna
name.
pause it here on LSD because I accidentally started the next game.